man has now pleaded guilty for a multi-year scheme of actually posing as a federal agent and getting away with it. Let's put this picture up for a mass here. This is an interesting saga. Washington, D.C. A Washington, D.C. man accused of a multi-year scheme to pose as a federal agent pleaded guilty to charges from the ruse and has agreed to cooperate with the government's investigation. His name is Arian Taherzadeh, 40 years of age. He sent these photos to a witness showing him with police gear in his apartment, including cases meant to carry firearms. That picture is from the US Department of Justice. He actually admitted to creating a private law enforcement company, an investigative service called, and I quote, the United States Special Police. That was the name of it, the United States Special Police. And using that organization, that company, to pretend to be a federal agent with the Department of Homeland Security, the Department of Justice, and other federal agencies. He also claimed to be a former Army Ranger, a former US Air Marshal, a special agent with Homeland Security, and a member of some multi-jurisdictional task force. On Monday, he pleaded guilty to one federal conspiracy charge, two violations of DC law, unlawful possession of a large capacity ammunition feeding device, and voyeurism. The scheme began when? In December of 2018. It continued all the way to 2022. So this individual, Arian, used his fake affiliation with the federal government to recruit other people to the United States Special Police and defraud the owners of three luxury apartment complexes by securing leases and then failing to pay more than $800,000 in unpaid rent, fees, and parking, according to the court filings. Okay, he was also in cahoots with this guy, Haider Ali, 36 years of age, was in cahoots with Mr. Arian. Arian and Ali were arrested in April for conduct stemming from the scheme. Ali has pleaded not guilty. The two claim to be investigators or special agents with the US Special Police, though the entity was not affiliated with the US government or Washington, D.C. Ali also allegedly made claims he participated in the arrest of El Chapo, that his family was Middle Eastern royalty, that he was a Calvin Klein model, and that a close relative led the Pakistani intelligence service. Additionally, the unnamed person was also involved, an unnamed individual was also involved, and the three sought to ingratiate themselves with members of law enforcement and the defense community, specifically by lavishing Secret Service employees with gifts worth more than $90,000. What in the hell is going on here? I mean, it seems as if they were getting away with this and would have continued to get away with this if it had not been for an outstanding bill. There's more. In one instance, Arian gave the wife of a Secret Service employee what he claimed was a government vehicle, and the worker and his wife a generator and survival backpack. He gave another a penthouse apartment to live in rent free for a year, and a third Secret Service employee with a penthouse apartment, drone gun locker, and Pelican case. What? They are literally giving gifts to federal agents and the family members of federal agents to bolster his claim and appear as legitimate, as a legitimate federal employee. Ali used photos of well-known government officials, which he obtained through his work as a driver with a car service, according to court filings. A sentencing date for Arian has not been set, though he is set to appear in court again in November. Four Secret Service employees, two are agents and two are uniformed division officers, were also suspended in April after they were duped in the scheme by them both. Now, were they really duped? I have questions. Adrienne, can you make sense of any of this?
Well, it sounds like someone was bored and thought they were maybe in some kind of Netflix film. Like, are you kidding? you said Calvin Klein model, get out of here. At one point were people going to wonder, hey, are you telling the truth or not? And that actually tells me that law enforcement doesn't have enough women involved in the situation, because we would have smelled the lie with the quickness. I don't know what other men were out here saying, oh, well, it sounds logical to me. Like, get the hell out of here. Ain't nobody got time for all these lies. It should have thrown up a red flag to a number of people. The fact that it did not and it went on as long as it did, that's an indictment on the individuals involved, because you know, I've believed a few whoppers in my day, but nothing to that extent.
I mean, Adrian, you got a point here, because I agree with you. If they would have tried to run this game on a number of women in law enforcement, it would not have worked. These men obviously like the, I guess, gifts they were receiving. That's likely why they have been fired and suspended. But it is quite fascinating. You literally have a guy that says, hey, I work for a secret government agency that y'all don't even know about, and you're the government. And we're going to recruit you to work for us in this top secret, no paperwork government agency. And by the way, I model for Calvin Klein. It's unbelievable. Okay.